In 2008, the San Diego Trauma-Informed Guide Team was established in response to a call to action from a training that was given here in San Diego.
As the backbone agency for the MARC funding, Harmonium has had a part in the work that's being carried out with the guide team.
The San Diego Trauma-Informed Guide Team really gives us a place to learn about what other community partners are doing, what other resources that are out there, and ways that we can really start to leverage our collective impact. So it's shaped the foundation of just about all of the work I do.
It's hard to change a system. So having the guide team there and the support and the enriched networking with all my colleagues in San Diego County has just helped motivate me, provide me energy.
As I've seen the transformative power over the past 9 years or so that my agency has been moving towards creating a trauma-informed culture.
A trauma-informed work and resilience building is very critical to set up the foundation early on in our work to do early intervention and prevention.
Understanding where a person with whom we would like to build a relationship, regardless of if it's professional, personal, social.
It creates a lens and a frame that you can look at food security and public health in a way that really expands the access that people have to the information and how they respond. I think it's been transformative for my organization over the past 3 years because we're really being very faithful and holding ourselves accountable to what their true needs are.
I learn a lot from everybody's background. They have different resources.
Be able to say, I've been through that. I know what you're going through, and it does get better.
We work on a referral basis. We paired the right choices of food with the health education that we have. So whether it's diabetic hypertension, and we are really, really working hard to fight obesity in the area.
We're here at La Maestra showcasing their shipping container that was converted into a cooler. It really allows them to expand the variety of fresh produce that they're distributing to their patients.
What we realized is that families were having to come to all different food distributions and tell their story again and again. They receive a card like this, and this can be used at 25 sites across the mid-city area. So this in the emergency food system is what we call a client choice pantry. It's reducing waste because they're not getting foods that they don't need, and it's culturally appropriate.
Welcome to 50th and Imperial Gathering Place. What we did not want was another vacant lot on an already depressed community, including all of the residents here in this immediate area, and have them help with the design and creation of what you see here. So is this a resilience piece? Absolutely. I could look at the expression of people walking by. Really, they're uplifted. They're excited about something going on in their community that they're a part of. The community identifies their concerns and their goals, and the community makes it happen.
My name is Jessica. I'm 18. I've been part of Youth Voice for now 5 years. And Youth Voice is basically a program where we get together and we talk about our needs from our community. Now that we've been presenting, policy leaders and decision makers and adults have been really shocked to see youth that are now presenting and advocating for topics that are really hard to talk about. Like we've also presenting for sex trafficking at the Game Commission. Now that we're presenting on that, I think we as youth also feel empowered to also speak up and know that we have a voice.
Cherokee Point has been lauded as the first elementary school in San Diego to be a trauma-informed school. The idea is that the school is a really welcoming place that uses restorative practices in their discipline, and that the residents, the youth, and the parents become leaders. They learn about what trauma is and how it's affected them and their families, and then they learn how to help their community.
What we have created here is an opportunity for everyone to understand how trauma-informed practice and building resilience is relevant to the work that we're doing.
We've implemented and included mindfulness practices and strength-based approaches into everything that we do, because it really helps us connect to the children, youth, and families that we're serving.
The imperative is that we do something. The imperative is that we recognize that early relationships in the lives of children and across the lifespan is so important to well-being.